Ever heard of the golden ratio or the Fibonacci sequence? Well, even if you haven't, I'm sure you've seen them before. They can be seen on flowers and the sequence in which their petals grow, down to the patterns drawn by the seeds on a sunflower. It can be seen in the positioning of branches on the tree and, on a much bigger scale, can be seen as the pattern followed by spiral galaxies. Now all that is quite impressive, but how about we take a step back to understand exactly what we're talking about? Let's start with the Fibonacci sequence. The Fibonacci sequence is a sequence of numbers where every number is the sum of the previous two. Pretty straightforward, right? For example, the sequence starts as such: 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, and so on and so forth. So if we take this section, 3, 5, 8, and 13, 13 is the sum of 8 and 5, and 8 is the sum of 5 and 3. It's by using this sequence and associating the numbers in this sequence to differently sized squares, then connecting those squares with circular arcs, that you get this spiral-like image. The very same one seen earlier over the spiral galaxy. It seems that in nature, many organisms or natural objects follow this same pattern, such as seashells. Now what about the golden ratio? The golden ratio, like pi, is an irrational number. The number itself is usually rounded up to about 1.618. See, two quantities are in the golden ratio if their ratio is the same as the ratio of their sum to the larger of the two quantities. To put it simply, in this example here, A plus B is to A what A is to B. So let's say we take a line measuring 100 centimeters, and you separate it into two parts, one measuring 61.8 centimeters long, and the other measuring 38.2 centimeters long. In this case, both 61.8 divided by 38.2 and 100 divided by 61.8 are the same. They both lead to the golden ratio. But the big question is, how are these two principles related? Well, if you take the visual representation of the Fibonacci sequence, the proportions coincide with the golden ratio. The golden ratio is the limit of the ratios of successive numbers in the Fibonacci sequence. Therefore, if a Fibonacci number is divided by its immediate predecessor, the quotient will approximate about 1.618. Now, the reason nature often seems to follow the golden ratio is because it's the perfect number for circular patterns, due to the fact that it's an irrational number, such as pi. It's then not associated to any particular fraction. So just as pi takes you in circles, the golden ratio takes you into spirals. That is why you can see the golden ratio everywhere in nature, and wherever it goes, the Fibonacci sequence follows.